My name is Lee Arnold, and this starts a series of videos that tell one big story about many problems, including climate change, species extinctions, increasing inequality, and the debate about markets versus government. These are all getting worse, so we need to make them easy to understand and to show how they are connected. I looked for a good way to start to put everything together, and it led to this science book, Environment, Power, and Society, by Howard T. Odum, who was an ecologist. Professor Odum drew scientific diagrams with real flows. I colored and animated, plants being eaten by animals and people trading with each other, to build all the systems of nature and society, step by step, and to make it easy to learn how they work. These are different things, but the common shape makes common motions. They tend to pulsate, and this cannot be precisely predicted. But we will also see that when they are changed, they usually wobble bigger and more unpredictably. Now it looks like additional carbon dioxide in the atmosphere is restarting the extreme climate wobbles, such as extreme changes in temperature and storms, that occurred before the beginnings of human civilization. Coming at this time, it will be dangerous. So what are we humans doing? Two-way flows are good to show many kinds of trades and relationships, but to show all of the ways that people connect, I had to invent a new shape, to stand for a group, containing any number of people, even billions, no matter where they are located. This is an abbreviation. We all trade or relate to each other, and we do it under common ideas or a center of attention. As we will see, the pattern shows up in a tribe or social structure, in geography, such as a city with suburbs, in business, with a firm and its suppliers and customers, in the financial system, and in every other kind of intentional organization. They can have relations to each other, around the ring, and relations to the organizing center. And there are other basic features. Any group, even a simple group, works on inputs, to trade and redistribute. It reinforces itself and grows. Instead of the same inputs, they can work on different inputs. This is called the division of labor. Then they get better at it, so the whole thing grows more. They can unite into one for external relations, for outside trade or defense. And they have central ideas, which reduce some of the costs and risks of interacting, which lets them grow even more. And some ideas help them to join into bigger groups. These abilities make this group strong and flexible. They're always combined, making something very powerful. And we can look for them in each and every case. The shape repeats itself into hierarchies, such as from family to clan to tribe. This is beneficial, but it also causes problems. Number one, it removes most of us far from the decisions of power. Number two, the actors at the center partly control the surplus, and this may become excessive inequality. It applies to businesses and governments, too. And there is a problem for the outside. It compels everybody to use up the natural environment, just to stay in the game. To shred the environment, to clear it, even to poison it. This can cause big trouble in the other environmental systems. And not only in the webs, now we are starting to affect the biggest cycles of nature. So I developed this video series into a new way of seeing, not only all the little parts, but the basic shapes they make. These become like the characters in a drama. We will see how they work and how they don't work. We will see that our only way of purposeful organizing has both good and bad effects, and this will get us to our main storyline about how to fix it. First, I will build everything from the beginning, so even kids can learn the basics about nature and society. If you like this series, please pass it around, because there is so much out there in our new era that people no longer have an easy way to find good information. So, thanks for watching.